New York City has always been known for its humid summers, but climate change is making the streets hotter and more humid than ever before. Temperatures have been steadily rising, and heat waves are expected to become more frequent. The New York City Panel on Climate Change predicts the number of heat waves in the city will triple by 2080, leading to an uptick in deaths.
The most significant cause of human deaths from any kind of climate or weather-related event is from heat.
Cities are more vulnerable to heat waves because most are covered in heat-trapping concrete and asphalt, creating so-called urban heat islands.
Central Park and other green spaces can provide some relief from the heat islands as they cool down the temperatures in the surrounding areas. Problem is, the majority of green spaces in New York are found in more affluent neighborhoods where there are fewer minority communities.
Lower-income neighborhoods like Mott Haven in the South Bronx are much hotter in the summer than in other parts of the city.
I'm literally feeling the temperature. My body is feeling a temperature at 10, sometimes to 15 degrees hotter than what the actual weather and temperature is.
According to city data, Mott Haven has some of the lowest tree cover in New York. Access to air conditioning is also limited, making it very hard for residents like Barber to escape the heat.
So literally on days 90 degree heat, 100 degree heat, we're supposed to take our children to parks that have no trees in it.
African Americans are twice as likely to die of heat exposure than white New Yorkers. McPherson, who has been studying the issue of urban heat islands and climate justice for a decade, attributes the disparity to historically racist policies.
Racist policies over many, many decades meant that some neighborhoods were developed with parks, were developed with street trees as part of their design, and those tend to be the wealthier neighborhoods. Other neighborhoods were not invested in, and so they're hotter.
In recent years, city leaders have planted a million trees, distributed free air conditioners to low-income people aged 60, and started a campaign to paint rooftops white to deflect the heat. McPherson applauds the efforts, but says more needs to be done.
My hope is that we don't have to wait for a devastating heat wave to take much more dramatic action on addressing the causes, the fundamental causes of heat in the city, which is lack of vegetation, lack of reflective surfaces, and really helping those who need it most.
Karina Huber, CGTN, New York.